those of you who I don't owe money to, my name is Michael Joseph. I have the honor of being your MC for tonight. Now, you know, every MC needs a couple of really important things. And one of them is, tell me what this is, everybody.
A word.
A candy pen.
Let's get it all together. What is it?
A candy pen.
All right, so now my official duties start as your MC. We are so happy to be here on this day to celebrate this great theater. 61 years of playing their part. I'm talking about a little later right over there. Mr. Milan, he's there. We love you so much. But you know, we're going to start the program. We're going to do a little different because our special guest, our keynote speaker, has another engagement she has to go to. But she changed the schedule to be here with us today. And we want to thank her so much for being here. Yeah. First of all, I'm glad to call her my friend. I love her so much. But let me share a little bit about Ms. Tonya Allen. Those of you who may or may not know, she is the CEO of the, and president of the Skillman Foundation. Give it up for Skillman Foundation. She does a lot of great things in the community. But the reason she's in that position, besides what God put her in that position, is because she loves children.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
She loves making a difference. In her bio, they call her an ideapreneur. And some of you may have known she was part of that organization, a group of people who volunteered at that time to make the Detroit Public Schools better. And the fruition of her work, you see it right now, is the Detroit Public Schools are making strides and doing better for our children. But not only was she involved with the education process here in Detroit making a change, she's in the lives of people each and every day. And the Skillman Foundation is not just about giving money, even though I got an organization I'm gonna talk to you about called Farm. We'll get to know that. And that's Family Assistance Renaissance Men. Hey, Willie Bill, what's up, baby? But they're about making a difference in the lives. So when we sat around, who we wanted for a keynote speaker, we had this great idea to get Miss Tonya Allen. And we are so happy to have you there, my friend. I asked her, has she done any plays? And she said, no, Mike, I ain't done no plays. Well, you on stage tonight, baby. So please welcome our keynote speaker, Miss Tonya Allen.
It is really my pleasure, and he is right. I never have been in a play. I tried it out like when I was in fifth grade, and I just didn't have the confidence for it, to be honest. But so I want to just thank you for having me tonight. I want to thank James, the board chair, and I also want to just give my accolades and appreciation to Bruce for his leadership for so many years in our city, and in particular to this theater. Congratulate the actors and actresses and the playwrights who are winning awards today. So I don't know where they are, but Casaundra, Calvin, Jaclynn, William, and Sandra, congratulations. I told you I couldn't do it in the fifth grade, and I'm telling you I can't even do it now. I won't tell you what grade I'm in. But I do want to also just send my special thanks to all of the other folks who make this theater possible. Those who are in the creative direction, the actors, the artists, the writers, and the technicians, the patrons, and you, the generous community of the Detroit Repertory Theater. Your work is extraordinarily important. I often think about people say, what do folks deserve? And I always think that joy and beauty are birthrights. Mm-hmm. And that's what theater provides us, joy and beauty, right? And everyone deserves it regardless of your circumstance. This is why I am so grateful and appreciative of the Repertory, the Detroit Rep's commitment to foster cultural democratization of the arts and to disrupt racism. So to do so really requires, in my opinion, a robust and muscular love. That you have to feel obligated in a deep and personal way in order to feel committed to magnify the magnificence of the marginalized. So I want to just say that I believe that the Detroit Rep has been a crucial organization to the resilience of our city. And I also believe that it is going to be a critical organization to the revitalization of our city. Because when artists and activists come together, this is when creativity is engaged as an organizing tool and real solutions emerge. Essentially, the role of art, in my opinion, is to make the revolution irresistible.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
It has a compelling factor that speaks to people's souls, and that is what we need in this particular time when you see so much controversy and so much distrust existing at the national level, but even at the local level. We have to be able to speak to people's souls and be compelling enough for them to believe in a future that we can create together. So how do we do that? How do we create a thoughtful and meaningful way for the arts to be directly involved and critical to Detroit's comeback? I would say that the arts can prevent the setback to the comeback if we're thoughtful. Because we all keep talking about, like, there are all of these issues that we believe can slow our trajectory. All of these issues that can make us pivot backwards instead of pivoting forward. And I think that if we're going to do this, then we have to focus on three things that are going to prove, if we're intentional about these things, our comeback can be real. And I would say we have to be intentional about the flashback. We have to be intentional about the feedback. And we have to be intentional about the give back. So I'm going to tell you what I mean when I say each of those things. So the flashback. Now you all, how many of you are Detroiters in here? Like you, okay, this is home. So I can just talk to y'all like home folk, right? All right, so we know that as much as we love this city, and I tell people all the time, I'm in love with Detroit. But how many of you are in love or have been in love? Everybody, right? And I'm sure whoever you've been in love with has not been perfect, even the one that's sitting next to you, right? So I'm in love with this city, and it hasn't been perfect, right? So we know that our city, in a lot of ways, has an ugly past and a harm and hurtful truth sometimes. But we have not been willing to wrestle with it. And we haven't focused on bringing reconciliation and healing. And I would say that reconciliation and healing, in my opinion, doesn't mean that the damage never existed. It means that we no longer allow the damage to control us or our future. And where do you get that kind of ability to look to your past and to see your future, but through what? The arts. Mm-hmm. It is through the theater that you can see those type of behaviors and that you can curate a conversation that allows us to see each other in our humanness, not by our labels. And then the second, which I talked to you about, is the give back. Nope, that's not the right one. It's the feedback. Give back is the last one. I'm going to end with that one. It's the feedback. And this is about engagement. And you all know that engagement is more than just asking someone a question. Engagement is a two-way street, right? It is about the back and forth. It's about the ongoing conversation that you can curate, where you can grow opportunities to create community. When we have community, I think that we can do a lot of things. I think we can build together. I believe that we can cultivate our imagination, that we can see beyond what exists to what can be. We can raise our critical and crucial consciousness, that we can see and hear and think about things that we would not normally think or talk about or even have comfort thinking about. We can harness social transformation. That's what you can do when you have feedback. And there is no better place, in my opinion, to do so in the theater, where if we can curate in some form or fashion cultural equity, which basically means this, that all people everywhere have the right to inherit and develop their own intellectual, emotional, material, and spiritual traditions. That if we can do those kinds of things, that's when you get to feedback, where there is co-ownership and co-design of what the conversation is and how you'll talk about it and how you resolve those conversations. And then lastly is about the give back. So one of the things I love about the mission of the Detroit Rep, and this notion of, I think I created this word, it wasn't in the mission, but it's the way I like to think about it, disrupting racism. Because I love it because it really speaks to our ability in a lot of ways to do the small work and the great work. The small work is what we can do every single day, right? It's that constant peace. So a lot of times we talk about in our country, in our culture, we talk about success as being the epitome of, you know, that's where the humanity, your success of your humanity is to be a successful person. Well, I personally think the epitome of humanity is to be a loving person, right? I believe it means to be able to give back and that we don't always honor those types of things. And so what I would say about the give back for us and connecting it to the mission of the organization is that I think we have to be really intentional about and hyper-focused as a city dealing with issues that we know can disrupt racism. That means that we have to be openly talking about, activating, and working on diversity, inclusion, and equity. Now, for you, if you've never heard all these words put together, I'm going to give you a couple of little definitions of it, of the way I think about it. And you may think about them in a different way, but that's the reason why we need the feedback, so we can talk about it together. But diversity, I always say in its most simplest definition, is basically counting the people. We're counting them. Who do we have in the room? Are they different? Inclusion is when the people count, right? It's making sure that it's not about who's in the room, it's about making sure every person in that room feels comfortable, feels like they have a voice, feel like they're seen. And I always say, when it comes to inclusion, you have to treat people, you don't treat people the way you want to be treated, you treat them the way they want to be treated. That's what inclusion means. Right? It means setting a table where everybody can sit at that table and nobody's sitting at a folding chair. All right. Right? It means we all have a place. And then when I think about equity, and I would be clear on what I mean by this, because I think a lot of times when people say equity, they hear equality. And I'm not actually talking about equality. Equality is about everybody having an equal share of something. We all get a equal part. Equity, in my opinion, is really about acknowledging that we all start at different places, that we start at unequal starting places because of the structural systems in our society. And that we work to put whatever resources necessary to make sure that everybody has an equal opportunity. That's different than everybody getting an equal share. And I believe if we're not hyper-focused on those kinds of issues as we go through this recovery, we will see a setback as a part of our comeback as a city. And that I also believe that they're crucial if we really want to think about how we start to dismantle the systems that created that old and ugly past where we do the look back, right? So I believe that the Detroit Rep is uniquely positioned to make this contribution in our city and in our society. It has the authenticity. It has the consciousness. It has the love to be able to do so. And that's the things that you need. Those are the core attributes you need to be able to facilitate this, so that we can do together the small work and the great work. So congratulations for 61 years of small work and the great work.
Yeah, ironic. I'll tell you about Miss Allen, which her work with education in Michigan and in Detroit specifically. But she always, as an advocate for the arts in the schools, theater, music. And remember, that's how the repertory started.
Yes.
Theater, music in the schools, our children. Mm-hmm. And we know how important that is. So again, we thank you so much. Thank you for your time tonight. Making our people who have the passion, who have the vision, and want to do the work. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to introduce a man who's going to introduce some people who are doing the work, who have the passion to help make this theater great. Please welcome the board chairman of the Detroit Repertory Theater, Mr. James Beans.
Ms. Maddox, when I call your name, please stand. Mr. Bruce Milan, please come up, please.
Good evening.
Good evening.
I want to make a brief comment about Sarge's remarks. I've often been asked about it. This is a little bit of an ad lib here. I've often been asked what the mission of the Detroit Rep is, and you could go through a long dissertation. But I want to emphasize just one little thing. The mission of this theater is to ignite the public, moral imagination. Now, I'm not going to explain anything. Take each one of those words, and you will find that the Rep is right at the soul of this. Now on to what I'm supposed to do. I never get tired of giving out the Rep Theater Awards. This moment not only gives me the opportunity to honor those artists who did exceptional work on our stage last season, but it also gives me the opportunity to express my personal appreciation to all of those performers, past and present, who have graced our stage and given us the benefit of their skill and talent. I also get the chance to express my deep appreciation to all the administrative and design talent, past and present, who with great dedication and sacrifice have contributed to the repertory's rich cultural legacy. Now I have the opportunity to present awards to those actors who were deemed by vote of our subscribers to be the best performers on the repertory stage during the 2016-2017 season. As a token of appreciation for their fine work, each winner receives a Puabic Tile of Honor. We had one consistent complaint from our subscribers. Making the final choice was far too difficult. So let's begin.
Two things, and you young brother, you remind me of it. I didn't thank God. Thank God for people like Bruce Millan and Barbara Busby.
Yes.
And then
yes.
I hope that all of you will place in your prayers, whatever your faith is, for our friend Cornell Markham. He has gone through a health struggle. He's getting better now, but he needs all of our prayers. So I ask you, will you join me in that?
Yes.
Praying for his recovery. Thank you so much. Okay. Now, as a close, the other thing I forgot to do, you know, I watched Ellen in the Oscars, so I can get myself in. I got myself in. And then we want to make this a very, very special night. First of all, I want to thank the Repertory for giving me the honor of being your master of ceremonies. And Leah and Bruce and Barbara, thank you so much. They ain't pay me, but I still came. but I came because you came. I came out of love. I get to tell you a little bit of my history. I was a young actor, didn't know what the heck I was doing, and I needed help. And I remember going to Bruce and asking him, you know, I want to be directed. And Bruce said, just sit over there and learn your lines. And then I had this teacher, this wonderful woman, who taught me stuff. Like, she would have me sitting in the summertime, y'all. What is it you tell me? If the office thistles, the thistles sit there, sit there, the thistles, how many thistles out there? I know, I really didn't want to do it because you'll give me some homework tonight when I get home. But I thank you for giving me, she didn't charge me a dime. And I want to thank you for your time, and more importantly, for your love. And by saying that, let me ask, is Harold Hogan here?
Harold.
And the last card says, just because you are who you are. But see, I'm not the only person that loves you. We're not the only people who love you. Your work has been renowned around the world, but especially in the city of Detroit. We have a proclamation from the mayor of the city of Detroit to Ms. Barbara Busby.
Oh.
I cannot forget this other beautiful lady, for DeAndres.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. But Dee was cool, but Dee taught me how to do this. On stage. And I taught her how to do this. She said, Michael, I already know how to do this.